subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about hyperparameter bias variance trade-off in k-nearest neighbors. In our previous classes, in naive-based model, we discussed a concept called hyperparameter underfitting and overfitting in naive-base. The technical terms for underfitting and overfitting is high biased models, we call it as underfitted models. High variance models, we call it as overfitted models. What we done in our naive Bayes model, we find the best alpha. Alpha is treated as hyperparameter. In this model, in k-nearest neighbors model, k is taken as hyperparameter. As k value changes, our model moves towards overfitting and underfitting. The same thing happened in naive Bayes also. As alpha value changes, the naive Bayes model is moving towards overfitting and underfitting. So we have to identify the best alpha value in naive Bayes. The same way we have to identify the best k value in k nearest neighbors. So that's we call it as hyperparameter tuning. So how our model is moving underfitting and overfitting, let's understand that with an example. For understanding of this class, we need a better understanding of overfitting, underfitting, and in our last class we discussed about the decision surface in k-nearest neighbors. So these concepts are very, very important to understand this class. Our assumption here is you have already watched all those classes. Please follow our playlist for better understanding of the subject. The link for playlist is provided in the description below. Let's take an example and understand what's bias variance trade-off in k-nearest neighbors. So the example data set which we consider here is we are taking 100 data points. Out of that 100 data points, we are having 80 positive data points and 20 negative data points. In our last class, we discussed about decision surface in k-nearest neighbors. Let's take this example, 80 positive points and 20 negative points. Let's take k is equal to 5. When we take k is equal to 5, what's our decision surface is? The decision surface is this. So what's decision surface is doing here? It is giving a graphical view of how our model is predicting. This side of the decision surface, our model will predict as a negative data point, and this side of our decision surface, our model is predicting as a positive data point. This is our decision surface. Let's take a negative point here. There must be a negative point here. There must be a negative point. Okay, so our decision surface is like this. Let's take our decision surface when k is equal to 1. So for k is equal to 1, our decision surface is like this. So when I take the point here, testing data point, it is near to negative data points. That's why in this area our model will predict as negative. That's why our decision surface is like this. Suppose if I remove this negative data point from our data set, means I changed the data set a little, a small change in data set, our decision surface is changing like this. For small change in data set, if there is a large change in our model, we call it as high variance models. Let's take this example. For k is equal to 5, if you take off this negative data point, still our decision surface is not changing. It is the same decision surface we are having. But changing in data, for small change in data, our model is not changing much. So we call it as, if our model is changing much, we call it as overfitted models. That's why high variance means our model is varying much, high variance models. For k is equal to 1, it's acting as a overfitted model. So now let's extend the concept to underfitting. As k value increases, our model is moving towards underfitted model. Let's say take an example and understand why it is changing towards underfitted models. We are taking k is equal to 45 here. Let's say at that point, and okay, we are taking k is equal to 45. So when k is equal to 45, let's take a testing data point here. So if I take a testing data point here, what's our model has to predict? It is in negative point region. Our model has to predict as a negative data point. How our k nearest neighbors is working? It will pick the 45 nearest neighbor points. But we have only 20 negative points. Overall data set, how many data points we are having? We are having only 20 negative data points. Remaining 25, automatically, what's the points it will pick? It will pick the 25 positive points. So what's our model will predict? It will take the majority class into consideration. When k is equal to 45, you take any testing data point here, any testing data point, always our model predict as positive, means biased to positive. That is called, we call it as high biased models. As k value increasing, our model is moving towards underfitted models. So what we have to do? We have to do a trade-off between high variance and high bias models. That's we call it as hyperparameter tuning. So in our last class, and we did coding for naive Bayes. We identified the best alpha. We did the coding, we did the hyperparameter tuning using a grid search CV. How we pick the best k value? How we pick the best alpha value in naive Bayes? As take the k value here. How we pick the best k? As k value is small, k is equal to 1, we are having overfitted models. Overfitted models means high training accuracy, low testing accuracy. This line shows the training accuracy, this line shows the testing accuracy. Black line shows the testing accuracy, red line shows the training accuracy. For k is equal to 1, we are having high accuracy for training data. For testing data, we are having low accuracy. As k value increases, training accuracy decreasing, testing accuracy increasing, and somewhere at some point again testing accuracy decreasing, means k, as k is increasing, our model again moving towards underfitted models. Whenever we are moving to underfitted models, again accuracy decreases. So this point we call it as best k. So we have to identify this k value. This we call it as best k. This we call it as hyperparameter tuning. This we will do in grid search CV. We already done the coding for naive Bayes. The same code applied for k nearest neighbors also. Okay, this is all about bias variance trade-off in k nearest neighbors. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.